My name is Hoogvliet and welcome back to World of Not Exactly What I Wanted to Release Today. What I was originally planning, a couple of weeks ago already, was a patch in a nutshell video like I did for patch 9.20. However, a couple of things happened. The first thing is I had a tooth forcefully excavated from my jaw. My jaw swelled up to the size of a baseball. I couldn't talk and everything pretty much hurt a lot if I did it. Eating hurt, sleeping hurt, existing hurt. Yeah, the pain of existence is great. Anyway, so if I have to then do a weird Russian accent, that would have been impossible for me to do. So I had to postpone that video by a week. And I wasn't quite happy with the video that I was making. I wasn't happy with it. I tried to introduce a new character. It just didn't work all. I just wasn't happy with the video, which means there will not be a patch in a nutshell video. I will not go over what's happening in patch 9.20. What I'm doing, however, is a short trailer for the Super Conqueror that might or might not show up in this video later on. I am, however, playing the M10 Wolverine, a tank you haven't seen in the news that will come out this Sunday. It is top of the tree, E3, so of course I'm playing to get the T110 E3, because what else am I doing with my life? I play tanks. A load of tanks. It's great, because the Wolverine was, in my opinion, a great tank. I really enjoyed it. The Jackson was a great tank. I really enjoyed it. The T25 AT was shit. The T28 was shit, but I knew how to play it. And the T95 is just stupid fun. I know. It's stupid fun. You're not fast. I mean, in open maps, like, for example, Muravanka, you're a bit useless. But on Malinovka, you're great. On Prokhorovka, if there's no artillery, it's great. On city maps, it's great. I never thought I would actually enjoy the T95. It's a bit mental bananas. The thing with the Jackson and the Wolverine is that they have turrets. Turrets in a line that ends up without a turret. The T95, the T110 E3, the T28, and the T25 AT don't have turrets. So, why are they turreted tank destroyers in the line without turrets? Probably because there wasn't a really... You know what? No, the T-40 didn't have a turret. It goes from the T-40 to the M10 Wolverine and the Jackson. They too have turrets. I don't know. I don't know. I guess there were no better replacements. But they were really fun tanks to play. As of late, I'm finding more joy in mid-tier tanks. Say, tanks from tier 6 to 8. Well, not really turret because the matchmaking is completely broken. But I'm finding more joy in tanks tier 5, 6, and 7. Then 8, 9, and 10. I mean, tier 9 is alright. I enjoy tier 9 more than tier 10 at the moment. But I don't know. I always kind of neglected the mid-tiers because I was just thinking, oh my god, I want the tier 10 of that. But some of them are really fun. There's a lot of stinkers at tier 7, don't get me wrong. But tier 6 is a great tier. I'm probably going to buy more tier 6s and just play tier 6. You know, if you end up in a tiered game, sometimes it sucks. But at the same time, you can have so much fun. I don't know. I think I'm slowly starting to realize that World of Tanks isn't just about getting tier 10 tanks, but also that other tanks, you know, below tier 10 are also fun. It's not just... The tier 10 is the end of the line, you know, it's what you work for, but going up the line sometimes might be fun. I mean, sometimes the French tank destroyers were so bad. Also, I want this Top Gun really bad, so APCR and KV-5, let's go. We'll be right back. So yeah, that was pretty much what I was planning on doing in the nutshell video, and it never really came to fruition. So that was a Super Conqueror, and I'm actually quite excited for the Super Conqueror. It's had a buff on the test server. It actually has DPM. It actually has gun handling. It has 10 degrees of gun depression. It has spaced armor on the turret and the frontal plate. Historically, it had armor on the lower plate as well. But historically, it wasn't called the Super Conqueror, but it was a testbed for Hesh warheads to be tested on how it would react to spaced armor. So Wargaming is replacing, like I said in an earlier video, the fake tank, the FE-215B, with a fake tank, the Super Conqueror. But it's more of a real tank because it actually kind of existed. It just never saw combat or was intended for combat. So here I am playing the Panzer VII, the newest of the German heavy tank line from my family, tier 10 heavy armor. And it is becoming my favorite tier 10 German heavy tank. And I don't really know the reason. Let's try and figure it out. First, you have the mouse. The mouse has had a nerf. Instead of like a 10 second reload, it has 11 seconds now with a good crew, rammer and vents. Its armor is good, but it's fallible. If you don't angle the turret well enough, they will pen your front with heat or APCR, whatever their premium ammo is. With the Panzer VII, you see the lower plate. You think that's an easy pen, but in reality, you need about 260 millimeters of penetration to pen it. So if the lower plate doesn't work, the upper plate is not a pen. The turret has no flat spots, so if you aim at someone, they will guarantee pen it, like the mouse and the E-100 have. There is a weak spot on the Panzer VII, the turret basket compartment thingy. Basically, you have the hull, and then at the back of the hull, you have the turret. It's a rear-mounted tank, as you may see if you're actually watching this video. Below the turret, it's still rounded to fit the turret ring. That is a weak spot if you are slightly angling this tank. But not everyone knows this, because it doesn't seem like that could be a weak spot. So there you go. It's pretty much the same weak spot as the FE-215B has, you know, the tier 10 that's being replaced, that if you have it, will remain in the game. If you don't have it, you'll never get it again, probably. There's a downside to the Panzer VII, however. It's reload. Its reload is 13 seconds for 560 alpha. 560 is good, but the 13 seconds is terrible. It is really slow. I've had many, many times where I thought, wow, in the mouse, I would have had another shot. But in the mouse, I probably would have not been in the situation I'm in with the Panzer VII, because the Panzer VII actually has some speed to its fat ass, whereas the mouse is slow. And the E-100 also is a bit of a fat, slow tank. I'm fat shaming the German heavy tanks. Deal with it. So, the Panzer VII is the fastest of them all. It has the mid-alpha, I think Jagdtiger Panzer VII, Waffenträger Panzer IV, 560 instead of 490 or 750. Its reload is, it could have been better. Its DPM, like I said, it could have been better. But its armor, people don't really know how to play against it just yet, because you don't see them often. It's great. I really like the Panzer VII until people figure out how to pen it, and then I'll just, you know, I'll throw it in the trash, like the T-125. I actually haven't played the T-125 since the nerf. I don't think I've played it since it was nerfed. As in, the nerf happened, and I just decided to not touch it. I removed the crew, I removed the ammo. It's just in my garage currently gathering piles and piles of dust. I'm never going to play the T-125 again until I, like, buff it again, or something happens to matchmaking, or the tank, or whatever. T-125 for me is dead. The I-7 is a better tank, the 5A is a better tank, the Panzer VII is a better tank, the 113 is a better tank. The IS-4, if I get it, will be a better tank than the T-125, and the IS-4?
Oh yeah, I am at the KV-3, and it's still stock. Nope.
So yeah, I will not get the IS-4 for quite some time. The tank that I'm currently grinding towards are the T-123 and the FE-215B-183, because the 183 will also be replaced with the FE-217 Badger. Pretty much a T-123, but with a 400 and currently 20 alpha gun that might still change. It's on the super test. That will probably happen next patch. This game, however, was played on stream, and if I have a good game on stream, I'll usually, like, well, nowadays, copy paste it over to YouTube because like seeing it live is different than if I commentate. However, I was playing some copyrighted music, Twitch removed the sound, and then it would have just been pretty much useless for me to copy it over to YouTube. However, the reaction I had after the game to this being this game is something I did record, luckily. I will not get the kill on this batch yet. The batch will stay hidden. And let's go to the post-game stats.
That's atrocious. That actually is atrocious. Get out. Oh. Really? Really? That is an ace. $16 as well, though. That is very good. But that is an ace in this tank. 1,222 experience. That is confusing. It's my first ace, I think, as well. That is actually really confusing. I'm sorry. I did not expect this. Yeah, 6k combined. But it's a tier 10. And I only have 2 kills.